Well, good morning, church family. It is Tuesday, April the 21st, and I hope today that you realize how much Jesus loves you, how much God loves you, and I'm praying that today during our devotion that the Holy Spirit would counsel you, would come in and give you peace. And no matter what situation or circumstances this video finds you in. So I love you, I miss you, and I wanted to let you guys know that. So today we're going to be in Isaiah chapter 43, verses 1 through 5. Now I may be in this a couple of days because there's two fear nots in this verse, but there's also so much in these verses, but there's also so many other truths that come out of this verse. But today we're just going to talk about one of them. And today is not necessarily a type of a thing that describes God as God is this. It's more as God has done this and God does this. So it's not, the truth is not necessarily God is this, but the truth is God does this for you and for me. And so let's get into our verse and then you'll understand hopefully what I'm talking about. So Isaiah chapter 43, verse 1 through 5, verses 1 through 5. Says, but now, thus says the Lord, he who created you, O Jacob, he who formed you, O Israel, fear not, for I have redeemed you. I have called you by name. You are mine. When you pass through the waters, I will be with you, and through the rivers, they shall not overwhelm you. When you walk through fire, you shall not be burned, and the flame shall not consume you. For I am the Lord your God, the Holy One of Israel, your Savior. I give Egypt as your ransom, Cush and Seba as in exchange for you, because you are precious in my eyes and honored, I love you. I give men in return for you, peoples in exchange for your life. Fear not, that's the second fear not. Fear not, for I am with you. I will bring your offspring from the east and from the west I will gather you. What I want to talk about today is actually the very first fear not that I just read. It says, fear not, for I have redeemed you. And basically what today's truth is God redeems us. He redeems you. He redeems me. And he does that through his son, Jesus. Now, what does basically that mean? If you know anything about iTunes or whatever, and you redeem a card, there's value on that card. The card is a piece of paper until you redeem it, and you redeem it for whatever the value is on that card, or on your iTunes card. And God does that for us. He redeems us, and whenever he redeems us, he basically says this. He says, I am putting value on you. I am putting worth on you. God, through his son Jesus, gives us worth. Now, the reason why I feel like I need to say that today is because, I don't know about you guys, but there have been times during the last month that I have felt, call it my self-esteem or something, I don't know, just I have felt pretty pathetic, just to be honest with you. And I've felt worthless. But the truth is, God gives us our worth. He puts value on you. He puts value on me. He did that whenever he sent us. And he said, you're so valuable. He said, you're so valuable that I'm going to pay the price with my son. I'm going to send Jesus for you and for me. And that's what he does. He says, I value you so much. I put worth on you so much. Now, I want to tell you that because I know some of us have been teaching our children, doing home education, virtual education, and some of us feel like we are messing up big time. Some of us feel tired of it. Some of us feel worthless because of that. Some of us have lost jobs. Some of you have lost jobs. And your identity was wrapped up in your job. And because your job is gone or furloughed or on pause or whatever, you feel worthless. But I just want to tell you, God is the one who added value to your life. God is the one who gave you value. God is the one who put worth in you. God is the one who declares us and declares our worth, who declares us worthy and declares our worth. And I just want to give you that. So today, if you're struggling, if you're having a hard time, you know, getting up, taking a shower, putting on regular clothes, if you're having a struggle with that today, take heart. God has deemed you worthy. God has put value in your life because He says, hey, I love you so much and I value you so much that I'm going to send my son Jesus for you. And so please understand that. You have value because of what God has done in your life. He has, through His son Jesus, if you've trusted Jesus as your Savior and has surrendered your life to Him, He has redeemed you. He has placed value upon you. And so get up today, take that shower, no matter what's going on in your life, and no matter how you feel. Satan deceives us. Satan will give us these little things throughout the day. You know, it's not worth it, you're not worth it. But the problem is, not the problem, the truth is that God values you. Like God has deemed you worth, deemed you, not necessarily deemed you worthy, I don't want to say that, but He has given you worth through His son Jesus. And He's given me worth through His son Jesus. He has given me value through His son Jesus. So I'm praying for you today. I pray that you find your value, your identity, your self-worth in Christ today. Fear not. For I have redeemed you. That's what it says in Isaiah chapter 43, verse 1. I love you. I miss you. I'm praying for you today. I pray that you look around, find something that you're thankful for, and that you cling on to that and cling on to His goodness, because He, God Almighty, has deemed you, given you value. He has redeemed you. So let's pray. God, I just want to thank you for this time that we can be together again as a church family. And Lord, I want to pray for us, Lord. I know that a lot of times, especially as a guy, a lot of times our identity is wrapped up in what we do, our job. It's wrapped up in who we are as parents. And right now, there may be people out here that are just feeling like they have failed and teaching our kids, or just they're seemed overwhelmed or emotionally spent. God, my prayer is that today, they realize that they have been redeemed by you through your son Jesus, and God, that because of that, you have given them self-worth. You have given us self-worth. And Lord, I pray that today, through the power of the Holy Spirit, that everyone that's listening to this will grasp that and understand that because of who you are and because of what you have done through your son Jesus for us, God, you have given us value. And Lord, I pray that today that we understand that you have redeemed us. Lord, I love you and I honor you in Jesus' name. Amen. Well, church family, I love you. I miss you. I hope you have a great day today. You are valued because of what Jesus has done for you, and we are valued because of what Jesus has done for us. So I just wanted to tell you that today. God bless you guys. Remember, find the truth in God's Word. Listen to that. Turn down the volume of the media, turn up the truth in His Word, and in Christ there is always hope. God bless. See you tomorrow.